Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to answer the question, when dividing fractions, why do we multiply by the reciprocal? To answer this question, we're going to lean on what we know about equivalent fractions. All right, let's begin with the example where our fraction is 2/10. All right, if we want to find an equivalent fraction of 2/10, we need to pick some number, some multiple, that we need to multiply by both the numerator and the denominator. And let's say we choose the number 3. Right. In choosing a number 3, we're actually multiplying by 1 because 3/3 when simplified is the same thing as 1. So let's go ahead and complete that multiplication. Numerators first. 2 times 3 to give us 6. Then our denominators, 10 times 3 to give us 30. So here we see that 2/10 has an equivalent fraction of 6/30. And of course, I can simplify 6/30 down by dividing numerator and denominator by 6. 6 divided by 6 gives me 1, and 30 divided by 6 gives me 5. So here I see that 2/10 is the same thing as 6/30. It is the same thing in simplest form as 1/5. Now let's take this a step further. By taking the fraction 2/10, which is in proper form or proper notation, and making it into a complex fraction. We do that by first looking at the numerator. We have the number 2, and we know whole numbers are understood to have a denominator of 1. So we have 2 over 1 in our numerator, and now let's look at our denominator. We have the number 10, and we know that 10 over 1 is the same thing as 10, because again, the 1 is implied as the denominator for each of the whole numbers. Now we're going to fall back to trying to do the same thing that we just did, which is to find an equivalent fraction. But here, in finding that equivalent fraction, our goal is to make this complex fraction into a proper fraction. And we do that by making this denominator become the number 1. All right. So to do that, we need to multiply this 10 over 1 by its reciprocal, which is 1/10. Now, if I'm going to multiply my denominator by 1/10, that means I need to multiply my numerator by 1/10, which takes us back to the concept of creating equivalent fractions by multiplying numerator and denominator by some quantity. So here we can say that 1/10 divided by 1/10 is the same thing as 1 because the numerator, the complex numerator and complex denominator match. So now we're going to do the same. We're going to do the same thing we just did in the previous example, and we're going to multiply our numerators and then our denominators. So here we have 2 times 1 to give us 2, 1 times 10 to give us 10. So that's the complex numerator. Now to our complex denominator, 10 times 1 to give us 10, and then 1 times 10 to give us 10. Now notice, in our complex denominator, we've just made that into the value 1 because 10/10 is 1. And then we keep our numerator 2/10. And this is the reason why we multiply it by that reciprocal. We wanted to make this denominator 1, which in essence makes this complex fraction back, or turns this complex fraction back into a proper fraction of 2/10. Now we can simplify 2/10 by dividing numerator by 2 and denominator by 2. So 2 divided by 2 gives me 1, and 10 divided by 2 gives me 5. And notice that I'm back at 1/5. And let's just do one more example. Let's do 4/9 divided by 2/3. Again, following the same process, we need to make this denominator 1. Well, to do that, we need to multiply it by 3/2, which is the reciprocal of what we have here. We just flipped it. If I multiply the denominator by 3/2, I must multiply the numerator by 3/2. All right, once I do that, I do my multiplication straight across. 4 times 3 to give me 12, 9 times 2 to give me 18, and my denominator, 2 times 3 to give me 6, and then 3 times 2 to give me 6. As you see in my denominator, it's going to become 1 because 6/6 is the same thing as 1. My numerator is 12/18. Now I can write this as a proper fraction, 12 over 18, and then I can divide numerator by 6 and divide the denominator by 6, and this comes out to be 2/3. All right, the point that I want to make here is that normally when we teach this in school, we don't talk about the denominator part. We don't show this part here where we're making that denominator a 1. We just focus on what to do in the numerator where we say keep the original fraction, change the division and multiplication, and then multiply by the reciprocal. So that's what we did in both of these examples. So hopefully this explanation tells us why we do that, or better explains to you why we do that. As always, thank you for watching the video by ajspeller.com, and I hope you have a great day.